In this week's space news, Exolaunch's European expansion continues. Exolaunch, the satellite integrator company based in Berlin, Germany, have announced another partnership this week. This time it's with the UK space startup Orbex. If all goes well, Orbex plan to launch in 2026 from the Saxeford spaceport in Scotland. They are developing a micro launcher called Prime and a medium lift vehicle called Proxima. Here is a graphic showing the expected launches from Saxeford, although it looks like the first launch is now moved back into 2026. Exolaunch regularly appears in space startup news videos on this channel because they are actively working on partnerships with the smaller launch companies. For instance, they have signed partnerships with InnoSpace last month and the Spanish startup PLD Space a month earlier. They signed an agreement with Rocket Factory Augsburg in 2020. The CEO of Exolaunch, Robert Sprowls, has said they want to provide their customers, that is the companies building satellites, as much choice as possible. When new rockets enter the launch market or are close to launching, Exolaunch wants to be able to instantly provide the option of launching on the rocket for their customers. Exolaunch has recently opened offices in Toulouse, France, as well as Tokyo in Japan. In addition, Exolaunch have been busy upgrading their launchers to deploy more and bigger satellites. The ExoTube offering can handle everything from constellations of small sats up to 1,000 kilo satellites. Two new platforms are under development to handle larger satellites. The company sees itself as providing a helping hand for new rocket launch companies, as they have a great deal of experience talking to customers. The CEO of Exolaunch said, "Our team has more launch experience than many of the new launchers have, so we truly are bringing experience on what customers expect when they approach a new vehicle. And we're advocating for our customers, so we're able to bring that perspective to the new launchers," unquote. Exolaunch minimizes the hassle of launching a satellite, especially with new launch providers. As a go-between, the company can use its relationship with satellite customers and the launch provider to smooth bumps in the road and get customer satellites into orbit as quickly as possible. Okay, on to our second news story this week. Lux Aeterna raises $4 million for reusable satellite buses. Lux Aeterna, a US startup based in Denver, Colorado, has gone public with a plan to develop fully reusable satellite buses. The idea is that once the mission has completed, the satellite bus can re-enter the atmosphere, land, and the payload can be returned to the customer. The satellite can be reused for subsequent missions. This reduces the cost of the satellite bus since it can be reused multiple times. The startup has just received $4 million in pre-seed funding to help it develop its reusable satellite bus idea. There are a few cases where this idea could be of use. For instance, a satellite component company may want to test out new components. Having the component returned for analysis after some time in space could be useful in designing robust components that have a long lifetime. Lux Aeterna plans their first demo mission in 2027, in which the spacecraft will host a payload. After the mission, the satellite will fall back to Earth and land softly with the aid of a parachute, similar to how Varda space capsules land. Brian Taylor, the CEO and founder of Lux Aeterna, said the plan is that each satellite bus is designed to fly 15 times or spend a cumulative 15 years in orbit, whichever comes first. Taylor said he was inspired to look at reusability thanks to his time as a SpaceX Starlink engineer. "Even if you make a kajillion of something, you have to pay for material. The only way to get below that number is reuse. So our goal is to be less expensive in the long run per mission than the material costs of a single satellite that's disposable," unquote. The satellites will operate under a unique business model that allows companies to lease time on the bus in orbit. The model could also ease the blow for companies that suffer failures in orbit. If a payload fails 6 months into a 5-year mission, Lux Aeterna can bring down the bus and the payload operator can stop paying its lease. Okay, let's move on to our final story this week. Isar Aerospace raises 150 million euros. Isar Aerospace, the German space startup, has secured 150 million euros through a convertible bond agreement with Miami-based Eldridge Industries. Isar Aerospace launched its Spectrum rocket from Norway's Andøya spaceport earlier this year. The flight quickly went wrong, with the rocket plunging to the ground and exploding 30 seconds later. Still, that's normal for a space startup company on its first launch, and Isar already has hardware for the second and third flight under construction. The new funding will help Isar expand its launch and production facilities. Isar Aerospace CEO Daniel Metzer said, This investment demonstrates strong confidence from global markets in our efforts to build a new space champion, unquote. Isar Aerospace is one of the top-funded space startups in Europe, with the company having secured €550 million from investors and also from the German government. The company has also made a proposal for the European Launcher Challenge run by ESA. If it wins, it could earn another €169 million. 12 proposals have been submitted from a range of European space startups, so we'll have to wait and see who the winners are. Thanks for watching. Space News Live is on Saturday evening or Sunday morning, depending where you watch from. I recap the videos I posted this week, answer questions, respond to comments and chat messages, cover any missed news, and preview upcoming content. I'd love for you to join if you can. Be sure to like and subscribe so you'll see our upcoming videos. We make videos every week covering the space industry, with an emphasis on the smaller space startups that aren't covered so well on other channels. See you soon.